Hello students, this is the second video lecture of class 11th biology chapter 3 plant kingdom. In the previous video lecture, that is the first video lecture of chapter 3 plant kingdom, you know, we looked into that Whittaker in 1969 gave 5 kingdom classification. The 5 kingdoms were Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. In this chapter, we are focusing obviously on the kingdom Plantae. We would be discussing kingdom Plantae, or you can say plant kingdom. So we would be focusing here that plants are further divided into. So this plant, that means Plantae, is kingdom. Am I correct? So what all these are, like algae, bryophytes, what are they? You have already studied in chapter 1, the living world. है ना, सो दीज आर नथिंग बट दीज आर डिवीजन, है ना, किंगडम के बाद डिवीजन आता है, डिवीजन और फाइलम. सो फाइलम वी यूज फॉर एनिमल्स, हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डिवीजन. चैप्टर 4 एनिमल किंगडम, देयर वी वुड बी टॉकिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट फाइलम्स, हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट डिवीजन्स. सो दिस इज डिवीजन. ओके, नाउ अगेन इफ आई फर्दर डिवाइड एल्गी इनटू 3, है ना, क्लोरोफाइसिए, रोडोफाइसिए, फेओफाइसिए, व्हाट आर दोस? द फर्दर डिविजन्स आर नथिंग बट क्लासेस. सो वी रेस्ट्रिक्ट आवरसेल्व्स अप टू क्लासेस. ओके, अगेन इफ वी मूव डाउन टू फर्दर डिविजन, देन कम्स ऑर्डर, देन कम्स फैमिली, देन कम्स जीनस, देन कम्स स्पीसीज. सो वी हैव लर्न्ड दैट. सो हियर वी वुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन किंगडम, देयर डिविजन एंड देयर क्लासेस. So division and classes, we would be studying their general characteristics before moving down to algae. Okay, we I have given you a brief summary in that what all things we would be including in this chapter. Now here, if you observe, angiosperms are further classified on the basis of different classification system. Okay, so the first classification system is, the differentiation is artificial classification system, and there is a natural classification system. So let us look into what is artificial classification system. So this classification system of angiosperms, I am talking about mainly focusing on angiosperms. So in the angiosperms, the classification system, artificial classification system, is using only gross morphological, or you can say gross superficial morphological characters. Now what you say? But what is these characters? What characters should be included in this term, gross superficial morphological? That means in these classification system, yani this classification system is done on the basis of habit, color, number and shape of leaves of that particular plant. If you want to differentiate, you are differentiating on the basis of habit, color, number and shape of leaves. So these are nothing but these are known as gross superficial morphological characters. Superficial morphological, morphological yani external features. Okay, so this classification system is based on vegetative characteristics and on the number or the structure of androecium. So I hope you all are very very well aware about androecium and gynoecium, hai na. Androecium is the male reproductive part. Okay, so the number of androecium and the structure of androecium is on basis of that this system works or the classification takes place. Apart from this, there are certain vegetative characteristics which also involves these habit, color, number and shape of leaves. Okay, now also if we move more detail what this classification system involves, that is separated the closely related species. Now here this system is separating the closely related species. That means since we are focusing here, this classification system is focusing on only few species. only few species it is focusing on. Therefore, it is easier, you know, for this system to closely relate, you know, the species. You know, closely species to species this classification is given. There are many such kind of classification. There can be broad classification done. There can be, you know, a very detailed classification can be done. Since here few species are involved, therefore, you know, this classification system involves, you know, separating the closely related species. And what else? This classification system gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics. Okay, so according to you, what do you think this classification system is doing correct by giving equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics? What do you think, is this doing correct? Huh? Equal rights to men and women ko milna chahiye na. So is it correct to give equal rights to vegetative and the sexual characteristics? So I think you would be also not accepting this point, as you know that vegetative characteristics change with season. Sexual characteristics does not affect with the environment. Okay, the environmental changes, but the vegetative characters, these affect with the environment, with the environmental changes, with the surrounding changes, hai na? So this system, you know, this point or this characteristic of this system is drawback. This is not correct. So you have to remember what artificial classification system says is that it is based on gross superficial morphological characters. Why I'm focusing these, you know, a big sir term, because this is important. This can be asked in MCQ, hai na? So you know, you have to remember that gross superficial morphological character. Now what these characters include? These include the habit, the color, and the number or shape of the leaves. This is one kind of vegetative character. This is one kind of, you know, external, morphological, that means external features, external characters. Okay, here in case they are also, you know, they are saying that they are based on vegetative characters. Apart from this, they are also, you know, based on the number or the structure of androecium, that is the male part. That means it moved down to sexual. है ना, male female का आएगा जब sexual characteristics की बात करेंगे. So here also in sexual characters, you know, characteristics, it includes vegetative characters, not sexual characteristics includes vegetative characters, but I am saying this system includes sexual characteristics as well as vegetative characteristics, and it is giving equal weightage to both. That both, you know, both are important, but there is one drawback. We cannot give equal weightage to both sexual and vegetative, as you know, these vegetative characters may vary with the environmental changes. Hai na? Sexual characteristics won't. So this is the drawback. Okay, we move on to next type of classification system, that is natural classification system. What does this include? That is, along with external features. Here they were basically focusing on external features. Here, along with external features, internal features is also, you know, included for the basis of classification. In which? Natural classification system. So internal features includes what? Like ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology. Okay, I hope you are getting the terms. Anatomy, study of internal structures. Embryology, that means study of embryo. Okay, phytochemistry, that means the studying regarding the chemical constituents of the plant, what all chemicals or the chemistry is involved in the plants. Plant hormones are also included in phytochemistry. So these are nothing but the internal features. So apart from external features like habit, color, number and shape of leaves, etc., etc., external features, number of androecium structure, morphological outer structure of androecium. Apart from these external features, internal features like ultrastructure, embryology, anatomy, phytochemistry, all these features are also included in natural classification system. Here, such kind of classification system, that is natural classification system for flowering plants. Okay, this is a highlighted one, huh? For flowering plants. So such classification system, that is natural classification system for flowering plants, was given by Joseph Dalton Hooker and George Bentham. So George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker were the two scientists, okay, which were giving or were providing us some natural classification system, some kind of system on the basis of external features as well as internal features, okay, for flowering plants. Okay, done. Next, nowadays which kind of classification is involved, which kind of taxonomists or scientists are using classification system? Are you recalling taxonomists? What do you understand by this? The person involved in taxonomy, searching about taxonomy, and you have already studied about taxonomy. If not, please go through your chapter 1, the living word, hai na? Okay, we move on to here. Nowadays, phylogenetic classification. Taxonomists or scientists are, more involving these kind of classification, that is phylogenetic classification. Now, what this kind of classification system involves? So, this is based on evolutionary relationships between various organisms. As the name suggests, phylogenetic. Phylo, derives from the phylum, that derives ultimately from division, since we are referring here as plants. So in plants, the genetic relationships, the genetic comes, that means evolutionary relationships are involved between various organisms, and according to their evolutionary, ki pehle kaun aaya, phir baad mein kaun aaya, if you observe video lecture 1, in that I asked you to, from, if we move from algae to angiosperms, so algae are the primitive ones, ancient ones, and angiosperms are the most developed ones. So here, this is also a evolutionary relationship. According to the evolutionary relationship, we placed the different plants in different divisions according to their development, according to the evolution. So this is nothing but phylogenetic classification. Now this classification assumes that organisms, if they belong to same taxa, they have common ancestor. Okay, mark this point as star. This is very important, that okay, this classification system assumes, what does it assumes? That organisms belong to the same taxa have common ancestor. So I hope you are remembering what is taxa. It was one of the level of that hierarchy. We started with kingdom, we moved down to phylum or division, we then moved down to classes, we then moved down to order, then family, then genus, then species. So common ancestor, theek hai, agar same taxa pe organisms honge, so that means they are having common ancestor. So this classification assumes like this, and accordingly it classifies different organisms. Suppose if we are not having any fossil evidence regarding that particular organisms, so what can we do? We can use different sources. There are three different sources for if we are not having any fossil evidence. So the three sources are numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy and chemotaxonomy. If we talk about numerical taxonomy, okay, taxonomy we understood, study of different taxa of particular kingdom or you know particular hierarchy. If you talk about numerical, numerical that means this classification would be using with the help of computer is using number and code. So number suggests numerical taxonomy. So using computers, this classification system, okay, number and codes are assigned to all the observable characters. Okay, so we apply some number and codes to that observable characters, then each characteristic is given equal importance. And you know, at the same time you can compare hundreds of characters, okay, hundred of characters can be considered at the same time. Why? Because each character is given equal weightage and each observable character is given number and codes. That becomes easy for you to arrange, and you can compare hundreds together with the help of computers. So this is one of the source. Another source is cytotaxonomy. Cyto comes from cytology, that means something related to cell. So this classification is on the cellular level, that means it is based on cytological information like chromosome number, its structure and behavior, that means something related to cell. So by studying cell, you can classify on the basis of this cytological information, which involve chromosome number, structure and behavior. If we move on to chemotaxonomy, chemo comes from chemical. So using chemical constituents of plant, you can classify the plants. So these are the three sources. When you do not get any fossil evidence, you can use these three sources to classify. What are those three sources? Numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy and chemotaxonomy. Nowadays most preferred type of system you can use for classification is the phylogenetic classification system, which is based on evolutionary relationship. And what does it assumes? That if the organisms are belonging to same taxa, okay, then they might be having common ancestor. They are assuming that. Also, what did we study? That there are two classification system, artificial and natural. Artificial classification system was based on the gross superficial morphological characters. Okay, habit, color, number and shape of leaves, okay, on the number or structure of androecium. These kinds of characteristics were involved in artificial classification system. Also, it gave equal weightage to vegetative and sexual characteristics, which won't be acceptable. Why? Because these vegetative characters would change according to the environment. If environment change occur, the vegetative characters would also change. Okay? Although sexual characteristics won't change. So how come we can give equal weightage? Then to also the system gear. So we have to study. Apart from this, if we talk about natural classification system. Okay. So this, along with external features like the habit, color, number and shape of leaves, number and structure of androecium. Apart from this, this natural classification system also involves internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, cytology, okay, embryology, phytochemistry, all these internal features, if we want to inculcate, then the natural classification system would include. Such kind of classification system for flowering plants was given by Joseph Dalton Hooker and George Bentham. So these were the two scientists, okay, who on the on the basis of this internal features and external features, they gave natural classification system. Okay, so this was all about classification system. In the next video lecture, we would be starting with algae, their general characteristic. This algae is nothing but division of kingdom Plantae. Okay, then after studying general characteristic of this division, we would be moving down to the characteristics of its classes, in case if we talk about algae, there is chlorophyce, rhodophyce and phaeophyce. So their characteristics. Okay, so in the next class or in the third video lecture, we would be starting with the algae.